Hello and welcome to Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the biggest entertainment stories. If it's not on Tea Time, like I always say, then it's not big enough. My name is Elsie Godwin, and I've got my co-anchors with me, Ife Oluwosunke and Ife Omai.
What's good?
Hi.
How you doing?
Oh, you don't cheers with...
No, come on, man. It's allowed. This is tea time.
You're forcing me to do this.
It's tea time.
La Ojuka, Life TV.
What happened?
Nothing. Nothing, darling. Nothing.
The look at you just say, Chineke Mo.
I mean, everybody knows that I have a lot of localism in me.
It's like,
it's allowed, eh?
Mm.
Oh, allowed.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I'm just my real self.
Mm.
I'm not trying to be foreign.
Mm.
Are you okay now?
Yeah, I'm good, darling.
Can we move on?
Yes, we can.
Okay. Runtown's music video for his 2016 smash hit, Mad Over You, has hit 100 million views on YouTube. The video was released on YouTube in December 2016, and of course, Clarence shot it. Music was produced by Delby. Congratulations to him. The song reigned for
forever.
I'm still mad over it.
Yeah.
Mad over you.
Still mad over the song.
I'm sure if there was a science to music, they'd probably use that. It was just perfect. It engages you from beginning to the end.
And the fact that it had that.
And it kept topping the charts for a long time. It was difficult to now say this was when the song was dropped. It was 2016, 2017, 2018. What's going on? Yeah. But whatever sauce was in that stew made for
did.
The. It worked.
Well, big shout out to every other person that has crossed the 100.
Yeah, I noticed that some people don't just. Blow their trumpets.
Yeah,
while I was listening, I saw Technopana is
that
about 116
really?
Million.
119, no, yeah, 119. What's it called? Yemi Alade, he's 110.
No, we celebrated that one.
Yeah,
of course, Yemi Alade blows her trumpet.
And Sinach.
That's the highest.
Yeah, no,
that's the
Fall.
Highest.
Four by David.
How many?
157 million. And
okay, how
many? 140.
160
now?
Yeah.
Okay. I know you told me that this glasses is recommended. Well, I told you to go and wash it.
No, I wasn't wearing it when I was doing my research.
Okay.
Once I checked, I was like,
160 million now?
Yep.
For real?
Mm. Yep.
So.
Which of her? Which
okay,
of
maybe,
her?
Waymaker.
Waymaker.
That song was powerful.
Yeah.
It's still powerful, yeah.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
So it's also nice to see women are up there as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to have to put
it
in there.
No, it's not even about the women. It's the genre now. She does gospel. Do you understand?
Yeah, but what are the odds that gospel is going to take 160 million?
Do you understand? That was what blew my mind. I was like, wow, nice.
Also, those names are, apart from David,
going forward,
I wouldn't
Christians
even...
have money for data now. What's the problem?
Wowzy.
You're going to say something.
I was going to say, those names, except from Davido, they're not, steady, hit makers, in my opinion. Maybe Yemi does really well outside of Nigeria. She has an African crowd. But someone like Techno, I feel like, I had to Google even the panel. Well.
You know, Techno went through some serious health issues.
Oh.
I think, was it last year or last 2 years?
Last,
and he's
last
just
year.
Coming back into the music scene again. But then he has some smashing singles that he's dropped between
Panna 2 is a big hit.
Oh,
between
Panna,
late,
I remember Panna, everybody was
now.
Dancing to Panna. That's
baby,
how I heard it
Panna.
Through the dancing community.
Hey. Why did you stop like that?
He's out.
Okay, since Ife doesn't want me to shine today, so let's just move on to the next story. Dwayne Johnson, popularly known as The Rock's daughter, Simone Johnson, signs with WWE to become a wrestler, and she begins training at its performance center in Florida. The 18-year-old, who is the only child of Dwayne Johnson and his ex-wife, has the full support of her father. Johnson's grandfather, Rocky Johnson, and great-grandfather, High Chief Peter Mevia are both WWE Hall of Famers. Okay, runs in the family, basically, right?
Yeah, it's the fourth.
Just
the fourth
lady. She's a woman, so.
Mm.
She'll be the fourth generation star. So
first female.
Yeah, first female, fourth generation star. So that is great. And then I think I like that she's following her dad's footsteps and she's following her family lineage as well, because. Our great-grandfather, our grandfather, our father, and then the fact that The Rock is actually supportive. I like that too. It's not like he has a choice anyway. She's a grown woman, so I think she would have still done whatever she wanted to do regardless. So big shout out to her. Just hope she excels.
I just hope. I mean, I've seen a lot of families that have that thing where it's not really spoken. I don't necessarily ask you to, but there's some type of pressure for the child to follow the footsteps. And I just hope. Yes, and I just hope it's not the case. However, this is. I'm not throwing any shade, but WWE is an act. It's like, you know, so it's not really some rocket science thing that she can't, like, you know, do other things with her life. No, you know, I've seen people who, like, are forced to do medicine, for example. Like, that's a deeper thing. Like, it's all your life put into something that you don't love. But for me, WWE is, like, you know, it's kind of loose and, like...
It's like going into
a... Yeah, it's like a side hustle type thing. So I'm sure, like, I saw the video. I didn't personally think that she looked happy. I'm just, I might be tripping. That's just how her face is.
Yeah, there was an interview that he granted sometime in 2018 when he said, how does it feel that, because this is something she has always wanted to do, that how does he feel about his daughter going into WWE? And he said they had the conversation. So she was the one who wanted it.
Of course. That's the same thing I'm saying. You can think you want something, but is it because you feel the pressure to want that thing?
Well, she's still young. I mean, time will tell.
And I don't think it's a bad thing. I mean, she might want
to do more than one thing.
Sometimes a platform is all you need. Do you understand? Like, you just need somewhere to start from.
Yeah.
She can end up like a father.
Yeah.
Do you understand? People would see her and then they'll give her other jobs. You know, she could be a fitness trainer. Yeah. She could open anything. But it's just that platform to start first. Yeah. You get it? So it's a step.
And I also agree. Like, I don't think it's a bad thing to also carry the family's legacy. Like, it's not always a bad thing. And if she's happy doing that, then of course I wasn't surprised that her father was supporting. I think he's always just been like that, even with other people that are not his kids. So yeah, kudos to him. I just thought maybe the mother would have said something, but in my research I didn't hear anything.
She looks so much like a mother though.
More so than the father.
Yeah, the father, yeah.
Okay, it's time for a quick break. When we return, we have more to discuss. Welcome to Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the biggest entertainment stories and, of course, analyze them for you.
You can have both parents and still end up as a useless child. I see them every day.
Most times, I worry more about where I'm coming from and where I am now. Wow. And that determines my next step.
Why are you sounding like Alibaba right now?
Plus TV Africa, we're feeling good. No time to dull, everybody feeling all right.
And people are still buying. That's why they look myself minimal IU.
Apala music is for mature minded people. I got DMs sometimes from Malawi, like,
sleeping early.
Sleeping early.
Welcome back. This is Still Tea Time on Plus TV Africa. Before we move on to the next story, we need to correct some figures. who is reporting who? Ife or Ife?
Okay, so when we're talking about
figures,
figures for the 100 YouTube million views. Streams, we're talking about the highest views, and we're deliberating whether it was Sinatra or Davido. So, but we just checked, fact check, and Sinatra has about 140 million, and Davido has 157. So Davido is still the highest.
Cool. Risky girl, your body risky. Okay, so former Big Brother Nigeria reality star Tacha calls out a hotel after an intruder accessed her room with master key. She made this known via Instagram page during a live video recording. According to her, she was lying down inside the room when a stranger walked into her room. She said the young man gained access to the hotel room with a master key, and then when he got in, the unidentified man walked towards her with a school bag and kept asking the reality star if she was the owner of the item. So from what I read, the manager spoke to her and they tried to pacify her and to tell her, it won't happen again, we're sorry, you know how Nigerian we can be. But she said, nah, you know, I'm moving out of this hotel. But I think she's right to feel that way and to call them out, because I don't understand how somebody would come into your room with a master key and the person isn't trying to apologize to say, oh, sorry, I'm in the wrong room. My sister's asking you, who is the owner of this school bag? Just, look, I don't know.
I didn't understand the story. Did the person bring the school bag to mm-hmm. say, is this yeah. your school mm-hmm. bag?
Yeah.
As in, why did she say the item? Who saw the video? I didn't see the video.
No, it was a live video of her just talking. Yeah, so, okay. Because I know that with hotels, you need a master key. So she kept emphasizing, like, use a master key to open
is
the door.
Is it a staff?
Like, yes, it's a staff.
Okay, so...
Who has the master key? If you go out, like, let's say you're sleeping there overnight, they're going to use a master key to mm-hmm. clean your room and things like that. What I kind of lost, I was lost in transmission when she said, he then asked if the school bag was hers. Mm-hmm. Like, was he coming into the place to rob the place with the school bag and was just asking her, or did he actually think that Tacha owned this school bag. It didn't make any sense.
Well, I think if we had seen the video, maybe it would have made more sense because it's always good to hear from the horse's mouth, right? Mm-hmm. But reading it, I didn't get it either. I was like, okay, is this person a staff? Was the person trying to bring something to you? Because
whether you are a staff or not, as long as somebody is inside, you cannot open.
That's why I said maybe if I'd seen the video. Maybe in the video she said he knocked, or she just said he didn't knock.
She mentioned that she just saw somebody. She was in bed. She just saw somebody walking.
What if you assumed? Okay, well, no.
I feel like you can't just walk into somebody's bedroom. And then I wish
even when they want to clean and they assume you're not there, they still knock.
Yeah. And even if that's the case,
because my dear, I love chilling in hotels.
So even when they are,
I'm a hotel queen. Yes, I mean that's how I chill.
Some people will be getting the wrong vibe from
you.
I really don't care. You're gonna say something.
Oh no, it's
good. Why do you know they knock when you're not there?
Because you're not there. No, there are times. Their cleaning is usually between 10 and 12. It depends on the hotel.
Hey, are you sure you're not a hotel attendant?
At some point? If I was, it's not a bad hustle. Of course. Yeah? But that's not the point. I mean, I know they clean between 10 a.m. and 12 p.m. So if, by adventure, you're still in the room, you hear them knock before they now come in, and you're like, oh, okay.
I think it's polite. If the person isn't checking out of the room completely, you know somebody's occupying that space. Yeah. Whether or not the person is there, you're supposed to knock. And if that was the case and they entered and saw the first thing would be, I'm sorry, but your school bag, and I don't understand where the school bag is coming
from. I think
hotels
need to work more on their customer service because... we saw the China video that went viral, right? Mm. Was it in China? Where they were using toilet brushes to wash dishes and use the same brush to clean the dustbin and all of that. They did, and it was an investigative journalism type thing where the reporter investigated like 3 different hotels. And they said most of the time they're pressured to complete their task for the day, so they usually just use whatever they see. And in this video, you could see them using the same brush to clean cups, wash the toilets, wash the dustbin and all of that. So I think a lot of hotels need to work on their customer service because this is not the first time that you'll be hearing. Sometimes you even see cases of theft, right? Yeah. Where you step out of your hotel and before you come back, your laptop is gone, your phones are gone, and you're wondering, like,
come is that on. Your experience?
Hmm?
Is that your experience?
I don't stay in such hotels, man. 5 stars only. They don't do where I go.
And you don't even know the time they clean, right? Mm-hmm. I'm just saying.
I'm never there when they clean. Sometimes when I'm there, I'm probably too knocked out to wake up.
Except you want to add something. I need to move on from this. Okay, David Adeleke, popularly known as Davido, has received certifications from Sony Music West Africa after 3 of his projects hit the platinum benchmark. The award-winning singer was presented with a plaque in recognition of the success recorded by his songs. The certifications were for his recent album, A Good Time, his collaboration with Popcorn Whiskey, and another hit single which featured Chris Brown. Blow My Mind. So the certification, there was a way the presenter called it. It was like, I think he got double for one song. And then one for the album and one for another song. So that's basically 2 million copies sold for one of the songs and then 1 million, 1 million each. So, yeah.
Yeah, congratulations. So that's one platinum for the album, double for Risky, and one for Blow My Mind. So I think it's Risky. Recommended.
You know, I was thinking about, like, the Grammy Awards and Burna Boy and all of that stuff. And I noticed that a lot of attention was going into Burna Boy. And I said to myself, like, it's nice, he deserves it, but, like, he's not the only person. And when I said that, I was thinking about Davido. So I was kind of happy to read this news.
He's not
that
the only person that
was? It felt like Burna Boy was the only one getting that international record, that Grammy noise as of last deal, year. Like, I'm sorry?
You can't even compare this, because this you apply.
You apply to get what?
To get your
You don't
platinum.
Think you apply?
No, you don't apply to get
Yes, you do, darling.
Goodness. How do you apply for your platinum?
Because when you have sold a certain... So, one unit. So, I have this, and I think it should be popping out on the screen soon. Mm-hmm. So, for the requirements, the platinum is actually when you sell 1 million units, right? And each permanent digital album or physical album sale is one unit for certification purpose. 10 permanent track downloads for the album count as one unit for clarification purpose. So requests for certification may be made by email to RIA, which is the what's the body again? I'll get the full name later. So the following information must be made available: record company, label, artist, title. Mm-hmm. So for certification, you send a mail.
Well,
a
I'm not even.
For
it's
certification.
The same thing for Grammys.
That's
you
what I was
apply.
Just going to say.
And that's what. So why are you saying
no,
that? You have
no, you're the no, one no, that no. just. You're the one that said it's not the same. That this one.
What I'm
for.
Saying. What I'm saying about application now in both senses. Mm. I mean. If you have not gotten the 1 million copies sold, you cannot come out to say, I'm applying. But for Grammys, as long as you have a good song, a body of work, and you feel it is great, you apply. That's what we're saying.
It shall not be it's same. Not Grammy, and this is not okay. the same.
I'm not comparing anyway, them in the though. Same yardstick. Mm-hmm. All I'm saying is that Burna Boy had a lot of international noise. He was on Jimmy Fallon. He was on this.
Yeah,
he was on that. He was
a pretty
yeah.
Good job.
And I was just saying to myself personally, it's not a fact. It's not a standard that you know he's not the only person doing really good music. Mm-hmm. I'm not a huge fan of Davido, but you can't remove the fact that he's a hard
Very
worker and he keeps putting music out there to entertain. Fans, which is what an artist should be. So when I saw that, I was like, okay, this is really cool. You know, not everyone can boast of that. And I feel like Davido getting that acknowledgement is good because he's just one of the rare people to me, especially apart from his music. Like, he's a people's person as well, and he helps his team and all of that stuff. So if I'm going to go back to the story of Chioma and her thingy.
But sorry, before we even go into Chioma, this is not the first time. I think 4 was Diamond and what's it called? If was double platinum as well. So this is not the first time that Davido is actually going platinum. But I'm wondering what, because Chioma brought it out to the open. So.
Yeah, and I think it's been a while. I don't remember.
No, she didn't bring it out to the open, actually. Sony Music West Africa tweeted about it first, and then in her own bid to congratulate her husband or man, she said, congratulations, my husband. And people decided to focus on that because to say, you're not married yet.
And
you
Nigerians,
just have your introduction,
and
baby.
Are so mean. They said, nah, introduction you do, you never marry you.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what's your business?
I don't want to be a hater. I think that if a regular person can call her what's it called?
Boyfriend.
Her boyfriend, hubby, or husband, or whatever. But deep down, you know that you are baying, that you are being forward.
Hey,
because
you're not actually.
I just know that for a fact. Like, okay, so even I am engaged. When people say your husband, I'm like, I'm not married. Because the truth of the matter is, I only know today. Today, I'm engaged. Nobody knows what's going to happen tomorrow. I'm not speaking bad or anything, but that's just facts, right? Now, if you now put that on a higher platform, where you're now speaking of like Davido and Chioma, and they have a baby together and all of that stuff, even that response to me was just a bit like weird. But okay,
does he need to talk? Like, does he need to respond to everything?
Of course. Okay, wait. She congratulated him, so he should have been mute. If he had been mute, they would still drag him and say, "Ah, Chioma."
There's nothing wrong with her.
There's nothing wrong with her.
My husband. It's just
what I'm saying.
But she knows
the fact of the matter is she's not the wife.
Yes, and. That's not her husband.
What they're saying.
Yes, and she knows what she's doing.
They've gone as far as he engaged.
Do you follow the rumors around David? And just I don't like amplifying these rumors, but do you follow them?
Yeah, I know.
You know about the supposed wife in the United States of America, right?
Hmm.
Oh, you're not following that part. Okay, like I said, I don't like.
Why are we not spit this tea? This tea still. Are they still making this tea?
I don't know, but it is their personal life.
So, Davido is married in the US.
Oh, really?
No, I'm asking. Allegedly. Davido is allegedly married in the US.
So I heard, I don't know.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, either ways, it's not, he's not your husband, but it's not a crime.
Not yet.
It's not a crime calling
well, I love
that person
relationship.
Your, yeah.
I'm happy for them.
It's cute.
They shared the introduction.
Okay. It's like they give you rice for this.
Have you forgotten
the
that...
The ginger is serious.
Have you forgotten that Ewa... Don't let... Ah, Ewa will come back for you people. Don't even go there. Ewa that was there
Dublin,
that she went for the Omugo.
Mm-hmm. I think it would be nice for Davido to settle. And if she's a... I don't know anything about her, but if she's a nice girl, like, I wish them all the best. But she knows. She cannot tell me that she didn't put that caption even for clickbait because she knows that she is technically a baby mama to Davido. Like, that's a title on its own.
But I think
and if you fast forward them.
Is she not?
She's not just a baby mama.
Oh, what is she?
I feel like they're in a good place because even with all this.
Is a baby mama's not in good places? I don't understand.
She's more than a baby mama to Davido. That's the way I see it. I get where you're coming from, but I think she's a whole lot more than a baby mama. I think he really adores her because.
I think. Okay, maybe because baby mamas to a lot of people is condescending, but it's not such a bad thing.
No,
like,
it's not a bad thing,
if you're somebody's.
Most time in this part of the world, to be precise, when you say you're a baby mama, it's either the daddy of the child is no longer in your life.
Yeah.
Whether she's a baby mama or mommy daddy or the wife, they are still together, right? And they are still dropping comments on each other's IG page. They are still following each other. Oh, they followed back, right?
Yeah,
so
they followed back.
It's cool. Good luck to them. And that's how I wrap up this episode of Tea Time. Thank you for watching. And do watch this episode all over again by visiting and subscribing to our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. Remember to drop your comments, though. And you can also watch Tea Time on Auto TV and in London on Ben Television. My thank you, as always, to go to my co-anchors, Ife Omai and Ife Oshonkaye, and the entire production team. Thank you for watching Plus TV Africa's Tea Time. My name is Elsie Godwin. Stay with us.